Once everything's installed and torqued down and you're ready to put your lower timing cover back on, either install a new gasket here on this upper oil pan or put a bead of right stuff through there and put the lower gaskets and this center gasket on and wire up your tensioner so it doesn't get very much slack in it. You could have zip tied or wired this tensioner the whole time if you wanted to. Just make sure it's wherever you're tying it's above this seam here so you can get it back off. Cleaning up the timing cover, I took an 1 13/16 3/4 inch drive socket and drove the seal out. I think his seal was leaking, so it's kind of a good time to change it. Drive it from the back to the front. Clean up all these surfaces. I just stuck the bolts, made holes with a Phillips screwdriver and a piece of cardboard and put the bolts in a pattern to come out of. Clean the surfaces off where the water pumps at, degrease it. Put a new crank seal in it. Has gaskets on this part here and around the center part, like metal shims. Ooh, look there where the chain was getting in trouble. That's nice. Some metal filings. The wool filter had quite a few metal filings in it. There's a piece of guide still laying in there. The oil pan had metal filings in it too. That's some of the damage I was noticing the chain caused on the case, the timing cover case. It must start feeding off that reversing rail and over into the cover. And eventually through the cover if it lasts that long. I'm installing the new front seal flush. Once your seal's installed, give it a little coating of some slippery stuff. You'll like it. Get all the surfaces clean. There's no drips. Time to melt the gaskets. Went ahead and took a piece of heavy wire and bent a hook in it and wrapped it around this Venus unit. Hold that tensioner up whenever I take this block off. The tensioner doesn't have to have a bunch of tension on it, just as long as it don't get any slack to get loose on the crankshaft sprocket. Notice this center gasket has some raised up dimples to hold it in the block. Or the cover, whichever the case may be. And it's a block. And just make sure it's a little bent. I'll make sure it's flattened out. So that'll work. Okay, the three channel gaskets are installed. I made sure there's no more debris, dirt, lint, whatever on the workings in there. And I put a little hawking pucky on the very end of the dented hose. to keep that from dropping down mysteriously when I'm putting it on. Just a little dab of weather strip adhesive on the ends. I'll let that set just a minute. I'm gonna layer silicone on that upper oil pan gasket and in the corners against the block. These shims are installed. It's time to drop the cover in on top of that. Got my wire. This block shouldn't interfere with the cover. It's up above the seam. Okay, to make reusing that upper oil pan gasket feasible, I set the cover in there and got these two 13 millimeter bolts started till they just started in those dowel pin tubes. And went underneath and held the gasket back and took a 13 millimeter and was tightening these bolts down while holding the gasket with my hand and let this cover slide across the gasket. And once I got them pretty snug down, I come up at this other 13 millimeter bolt and a 10 millimeter bolt in this corner. And then I'll go for this center. Then put all the other bolts in and start spreading it out. But there's the gasket there. It worked well. Gotta hold that gasket or this cover will drag it with it. If I put sealing on it because I think it was weeping before. Plus, I didn't want to have to take the whole oil pan off of it just to replace that gasket. Yeah, it's really an outfit. I went with 7.5 foot-pounds or 10 newton meters on the 10 millimeter bolts on this lower timing cover. And the 13 millimeter heads, I went with 12 foot-pounds or 15 newton meters on the 313 millimeters, two on the bottom corner and one up on the right here. The rest of them are set at 7.588 foot-pounds. I also tighten these 6.5 in the wheel pad and one external above the power steering pump down to 10 newton meters. Looks good. I'm gonna take a zip tie that I've bent into a hook and reach back into this sump and see if there's any chunks caught in it. Seems like the screen's kind of floppy. Yep, and there is. Of course. Now I'll have to clean that out. Be sure and clean your pickup screen out. That can cause some problems, especially if anything else attaches in there. It took me 20 minutes to pick all the silicone and plastic pieces and little aluminum metal slivers out of that pickup tube. It was really packed. If you skip that step, you'll probably be putting the motor in it before long. Little slivers of silicone from previous work or whatever, and mostly full of plastic and little aluminum slivers. It's good shape now. I'd use a pretty stiff wire. That zip tie wasn't getting it. Put a little hook on it and just run it along the perimeter and pulled back toward the hole and pieces come a flying out of it. Once you got your pickup screen cleaned out, clean off your oil pan. I just use a fine wire drill brush on everything pretty much. Just don't push too hard on aluminum stuff. and lay your new gasket on there. It's decorative. And look at this green plug. I'd like to know why it's such a problem to put a drain plug on the bottom of the pan. But anyway, spray the residual oil off of the engine where this mounts. Start putting all the oil pan bolts back in it. They tighten down to 10 newton meters. Check for any metal filings. Trash. I got a solution to all these bolts on this oil. And so on. While I was down there putting the oil pan on, I went ahead and pulled the crank pin. This deal here that lines the crank on top dead center by going through the flywheel. I've got a wire pretty snug against this tension arm, and I'm going to back this bolt off and take this block off so I can put this top timing cover on. The timing's all set on it. Just look everything over for any particles, hair, debris, whatever on the stuff. I went ahead and laid the water pipes back in, put new O-rings on them. Put a little silicone grease on them. Slid them right in there. And took some 400 grit. Smoothed them up a little bit. Take just a little bit of dark ring off of it. I still got the cam blocks installed. Just till I get this tensioner put back in it. I took the tensioning arm block off. Gotta degrease this area anyway. There's an O-ring right here that needs replaced. That's the oil jacket for the tensioner, and then this is a secondary air injection. That all needs degreased, and these all corners on this upper timing cover needs degreased because a touch of silicone will be applied there. Tension arm still staying put by that wire I put on it. Like I say, you could use a zip strap if you want to. I just put a piece of wire curved around the bay noose. It's alright. As long as it don't come off. Even then, who knows? I don't want to try it out. I'm going to put this passenger side upper timing cover on just to get the tensioner business out of the way. Degrease your surfaces and your corners, especially for silicone application here and there. Install a new deep O-ring for the oil jacket. And you're supposed to have a separator plate to go on the valve pin cover and bolt it down and hold this down while you're tightening it on there. I'll use one of the valve cover studs in this bar and we'll see how well I'll just push down on it. Get it lined up with the flush with the head there to compress this seal here. Make sure all your torque specs are in. And then you can get whatever is holding this tensioner arm up back off of it when the cover's on it. I've got my upper timing cover surfaces cleaned and a new seal installed. I'll be applying silicone on this top corner, this bottom corner, and this bottom corner, and that top corner. Just a touch. Although I'm going to put the silicone down there on the corners instead of on this seal. It's good stuff. It's the right stuff, apparently. Okay, silk pins applied. This is the issue I'm looking at whenever the cover's not mashed, compressing this seal down here. And we can take care of that right at this point. Just need a spacer under it. I've got the cover down. If you've got access to the separator plate, I'd recommend using it. This is kind of a pain. I just bolted a double layered metal bar onto one of the cam bearing cap studs for the valve cover. Or head cover, whatever you want to call it. And you gotta stay away from your Venus sensor wheel on it. If you bend that, you'll have a problem. I just stuck some soft spacers underneath of the edge of it and pried down on it. I've run all six of those bolts down so they make contact with this, but they're not tight. Sure don't hit this plate with sensor ring on it. Do it this way. You can put big washers on the valve covers and pull the valve pan cover down and it'll get in the ballpark. Maybe you can put a spacer, a little thin spacer under, tighten the four bolts with big washers. Well, that's just faster. Get that top down where you want it. Check it. It's down. I'll go ahead and leave that some pressure on that. Now just check and make sure that this is level with the head. There's a nice ledge on this cover to get a pry bar underneath of it. And it's down. Go ahead and tighten the bottom too. Snug them down pretty good. Looks good. Done. I can visually see that one in good shape. Continue on like it doesn't have any interruption. And that's faster than doing all the business with the valve cover. Just be sure not to damage, get into this, one of these points sticking up. Looks good, it works. Now let's tighten the center ones down, 10 newton meters. 10 newton meters, I believe, is the specification on those bolts. Just make sure you didn't drop any trash down in there. Or hit that tune ring on. My wire's a little close in there to get out from underneath that tensioner arm. I just put a little bit of oil down in this and lubed it up. This tensioner plunger. Says it only changed the height of it about an eighth of an inch when you compress it down. And you got to put a new sealing washer. This tensioner comes with a new cap. The spring's substantially stronger than the original. So that's good. I get the new cap and aluminum washer to go around the new cap, seal it, and put it in there. Lube up the ends of it and inside of it a little bit. I put just a little bit of oil in the bottom of the cap too. This is all perfectly clean. Now to stick it in there and tighten it to 40 newton meters or 30 foot pounds. And get my wire out of there. I just wetted the plunger down. There's not actually any standing oil in the plunger. Of course, you just don't know where the distance is going to put it if you fill it full of oil. You don't want to mash your tensioner against something. But I had to reach underneath and get it started. Now torque it down. 30 foot-pounds or 40 newton meters. Good enough. Let's see if it's still got a little spring to it. That's good enough. I'll go ahead and take my wire off now. That's nice. Just like downtown. You know, like I say, check for any debris in there. Clean it out. Looks good. Pretty nice.